Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're gonna see how to create this really cool dissolving text effects that you can see using Adobe Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. All right, so let's go and open Photoshop, and then I will go to File, New, and let's keep the setting as it is, and I will press OK. All right, now I will go to Adjustment, and I will choose Solid Color. And as you can see, I have it in pure black, so I'm just gonna change the brightness to 10. And this is very important, make sure to choose like a darker gray, but not a 100% black. So you can just put like 10 or 7 brightness and then press OK. All right, now I think I will change the background of Photoshop to maybe light gray. You can do that by just right click outside of the document and choose whatever color you want. And let's delete this background. All right, next I will create a new layer and then I will call it text. And then I will right click and convert it to smart object and right click again, edit content. And here we're gonna actually write our text. So I will go and choose the text tool. And the font I'm using is called Anton. I will make sure to put a link where you can download this. And you can choose whatever font you want. But in case you want to use the same one, I will make sure to put where you can download it. So I will one click and let's type something like that's PS. And let's place it in the center. And let's make it a little bit bigger actually. Yeah, something like this. And let's actually make these three letters smaller. Just like that. All right. Okay, now we'll close this. And then I will make sure to press yes to save the changes. And there we go, we have our text. Now this is a very simple effect to do. So basically what we're gonna do is to apply a blur and then change the blender mode and boom, that will be our effect. So let's go to filter and apply a blur by going to this blur gallery and choose field blur. Now the good thing about the blur galleries, all of them, they have the option to actually with this point that will give you the option to pin a point where you can actually control the blur. For example, I can put a pin in here and put like the blur very like too much, maybe 150 or something. And then I can put another one or I can pin another blur by just one click outside of it. And this will actually eliminate the amount of blur that we have in here. Well, not eliminate is 100%, but you know, you can actually control where it shows and where it's not. For example, if I put less blur for this pin in here, you can see how this will look just like this. So basically we're gonna follow the same step to create our effect. So we're gonna actually make a pin that is very strong, and then we're gonna make another one next to it that is less stronger or almost zero blur to create that really nice effect that you saw in the beginning. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. Alright, so once you are happy with what you have, you can just press OK and then wait for it to progress. Alright, next I will change the blending mode of this to dissolve. Now if I zoom in, you can see the effect that we are going for. But as you can see, it's a little bit stronger. So we're gonna fix this in a little bit. So to fix it, I'm gonna actually apply a texture on top of it. So I would go and open the first texture that I will use. I will make sure to upload this texture that I'm using for this video in the link from the description below, so you can download them. All right, so I will place it. And then while I'm having this texture above the text, I will make sure to actually drop down the fade or the opacity a little bit. For me, I will put it down around 70%. And now it looks a little bit less stronger, as you can see, but still it doesn't look that much. So to make it look more visible, I'm gonna actually make a duplicate of the text in here by selecting it and then press Ctrl Command J. And then I'm gonna take this copy and put it on top of the texture. And let's call this text 2. And for this one, I'm gonna change the blending mode of it. Instead of dissolve, I'm gonna put it to linear dodge add. And now if I zoom in, you can see how smooth the dissolve look, which is really cool. But still, I'm gonna apply another texture on top of it. So I will go and open the second texture that I will be using, and I will make sure to put it to fit. Yeah, something like this. And for this one, I'm gonna change the blending mode of it to linear dodge add, and then I will put down the fill to like 50%. And there we go. This is actually our effect. As you can see, it's pretty easy and simple to do. Now you can leave it like this if you want, but if you want to add some colors, I will show you how to do that. So to add a little bit of color to this, we're gonna use gradient map. So I will go to adjustment and choose gradient map. And let me actually zoom in a little bit to see the text. All right, somewhere in here. And then I will one click on this gradient map, just right here, to open the gradient editor. And from here, basically, make sure that you have the black point and the white point set like this. And I'm gonna add like two colors in here. So I will go and add one color in this area, and then I will one click on the color to change it to maybe a little bit of color, maybe blue, like a dark blue or desaturated blue. And as you can see, it will start to make the document look a little bit brighter, and that's exactly what we want. Yeah, so I will keep it somewhere around in here, and I will press OK. And now you can actually control the amount of brightness you want by moving this color. As you can see, if you want it darker, you can move it toward the white, and if you want it to be a little bit brighter, you can move it toward the black. And as you can see, if you want more details from the texture, you can do that. For me, I think I will keep it around 30% in the location, or 25. So let's keep it around 25. All right, now I would go to this area and I would add the second color I want. So this one, it would be the brighter color. So you can choose something like this blue, or maybe a little bit of turquoise or cyan. For me, I really like this one. So maybe I will keep it in this coloring here, and I will press OK. And this the same. You can control it by actually moving the location just like this. Yeah, I think I like it more toward the white. And you can actually use, or you can actually add as many colors as you want, but for me, I think I like these two colors to be in control for this document. And I hope it's okay. And there we go. This is basically our effect. You can see it's very easy and simple to do, but at the same time, it looks really, really cool. All right, so I hope that you enjoy and you like this quick tutorial, and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know, wait for more to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.